Hey guys, I'm at this ancient temple in India called the Panchavarnaswamy Temple, and here you can see something quite extraordinary. In a dark corner on one of the walls, we can see this amazing carving of a man riding a bicycle. Historians tell us that the bicycle was invented in 1800s, just 200 years ago. But how was this carved in this ancient temple, which is about 2,000 years old? Before we go into this, first, let us confirm if this is really a bike. Here you can see a man holding two ends of the handlebar and is in a sitting position on the saddle. One of his feet is clearly on the pedal. If you look closely, you can even see the pedal underneath. There are two wheels. This is clearly a bicycle. There is absolutely no doubt about this. And we have read in history books that bikes were invented in the last 200 years in Europe. But this carving does not show a European. It shows an Indian man with a large mustache and just a shawl on the top. His waistcloth confirms that this is an Indian. Is it possible that bikes were used in India thousands of years ago? Are we looking at evidence of suppressed history? To understand this, we need to learn how bikes work. To ride a bike, we need three important things: wheels, mechanical power transmission like chain drives, and the ability to balance your body. All experts agree that wheels were invented in Copper Age, which is about 6,500 years ago. Archeologists recently discovered a chariot with wheels in India, which is at least 3,800 years old. We have clear evidence that complex power transmission systems were used in ancient times. Not only do we see gears, we have solid evidence of lathe machining technology, which would be impossible without mechanical transmission systems. We invented the wheels 6,500 years ago, but why did it take human beings more than 6,000 years to invent the bicycle? Some experts give a strange reason for this. Since early human beings evolved from apes, they were not only unable to put complex ideas together, they were also not able to balance their bodies like modern day human beings. Today, we have learned to use our bodies to do impossible acrobatic tricks. This is an evolving art, but ancient people were physically clumsy people. But this theory is nonsense because carvings in ancient temples clearly prove that early human beings were able to do these great acrobatic tricks. They had better flexible bodies than us. These carvings are incredible, but that's another video. So we can see evidence of wheels, transmission systems, and body balancing in ancient Indian temples. Did it really take many thousand years to put all these three things together to create a bike? Or were bikes really used in ancient times? But what do mainstream archaeologists and historians say about this carving? They have very simple explanations. Some have argued that this temple was entirely built just 100 years ago. Since this is not an ancient temple, all these carvings are new, and sculptors carved what they saw. There were bikes 100 years ago, so it was easy for sculptors to carve this. Are experts right about this? Is it possible that this is a new temple built in the last century? No, because this temple is mentioned in the 7th century text called Devaru. This text, written in ancient Tamil language, clearly mentions this temple by its name. Therefore, this temple existed 1,200 years ago. There are not only inscriptions on the temple walls to prove that this is an ancient temple. This site was even recorded by the Greek geographer Ptolemy, who lived about 1,900 years ago. So this temple must be at least 2,000 years old. Other experts have claimed that although this is an ancient temple, this pillar is a new addition. But look carefully, this is not a freestanding pillar. If this is a pillar standing alone like what you see here, we can argue that this was a recent addition, but the bicycle is actually carved on the walls. It looks like a pillar, but it is in fact part of a large wall. This means that the entire stone block was a newer addition, which is highly unlikely. Some experts have even claimed that the wall was in fact an ancient wall, and modern sculptors merely carved the bike on the existing wall. This is impossible because all carvings are created at a raised level than the planes they are sitting on. If such a carving was to be made recently, then they would have to level the entire plane of the existing wall to make the carving stand out. If this was done, it would have been a major reconstruction or renovation project. But even after extensive research, I find there is absolutely no evidence to show that there were any major additions or renovations done in this temple. While I'm able to trace evidence of this temple and its sculptures back to as far as 2,000 years, I'm not able to find one single record of any renovation that happened in the last two centuries. So all these theories that this is a new carving are completely baseless. But why are archaeologists and experts coming out with these baseless theories? Their argument is simple. Since this is a bicycle and bikes were invented just 200 years ago, this must be a recent carving. If they even mention the possibility of advanced ancient technology, mainstream experts would quickly label them as pseudoscientists and they would be out of their jobs. But ancient Indian temples are full of these evidences of advanced technology. Remember, I've already shown you a telescope carved in the 800-year-old Hoysaleswara temple. We have seen advanced technology such as floating rocks used many centuries ago. We have seen clear evidence of machining in ancient sites. So my question is it possible that bicycles were used in ancient times? Or is this just an elaborate hoax? Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section. I'm Praveen Mohan. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and also click on the bell button to get all the updates. Please give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to share it with your friends. And I'll talk to you soon. Bye.